Hey everyone, this is your 5-minute daily devotional. Today's scripture verse is coming from Revelation chapter 3, verse 22. It reads as follows. Whoever has ears, let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. I was going through my daily work week this one week when I noticed that some coworkers around me were kind of going through just sort of some bigger stuff. At first, I didn't think too much of it. This one person told us that they had gotten this just an incredible opportunity. I mean, kind of a once in a lifetime opportunity that not a lot of people get to do this one particular thing. And we were just kind of all excited for them. We were just kind of, you know, over the moon, just very excited. But the more I kind of thought about it, the more I realized that, you know, for them to be successful in this particular kind of opportunity, it would sort of almost be like luck of the draw, kind of, you know, it wasn't guaranteed that they would be successful. This other person shared how him and his wife had been looking for a home. And I know that they had been looking for a while and they had found this one house that they were excited about, but then, you know, it sort of fell through. And then they found this other one and they were just like, wow, this would be so amazing. You know, it's exactly what they wanted, exactly where they wanted it. But, you know, he said, yeah, you know, it's just going to be a high competition because it's such a great neighborhood. It's such a great, you know, like high sought after neighborhood, high sought after area. This third person casually shared that they'd be out of the office this one particular day. We were working on a project together, that they would be out of the office this one particular day because of a medical appointment. And I don't know, it was just sort of the way they said it that just kind of stuck with me. There was just like the little sadness in their eyes and just a little something to it where I could sense that this wasn't just maybe like the run-of-the-mill medical appointment. Well, all these instances sort of, you know, culminated on this one particular day, almost as if God was saying, hello, wake up, you should be interceding on their behalf. So I got to work and I started praying. I prayed for that one particular person with that incredible once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, that they would have unusual favor, that they would just sort of know what they needed to know, that they would do like phenomenally. And I prayed that, you know, regardless of the market, that this, you know, guy and his wife would get the house and you'd be blessed and they'd have favor, and that, you know, whatever this medical appointment was, that, you know, it would come out, they would come out on top, they would have health and be healthy and everything would be well. It was like God was reminding me in praying for them that that was one of the reasons God had them in my life in the first place. But yes, of course, we work together, we work in projects together, all of that is good and fine, and we are accomplishing that goal as well. But really, when, you know, someone sort of drops a personal, you know, life situation, or they share some big news, or you can just sort of sense something is off, those also are the oh so sweet, wonderful God moments where God is saying, hey, this is also why they're in your lives. Pay attention, start interceding, start praying for them. This is why I have you connected to them too. Our verse today comes from the book of Revelations, and I think it's so beautiful. It's ending the letter to the church in Laodicea, and the Lord is writing to this church and he's telling them, look, you guys are lukewarm and I don't like it. It's just, ugh, I want to spit it out of my mouth. It doesn't even taste good. You have no passion. You have no fire. You're neither hot nor cold. And I wish you were one way or the other, but you're not. You're just kind of like blah, look lukewarm. And that should change. That needs to change. He tells them he is standing at the door and knocking. But will they open it? Do they hear him knocking? Will they answer the door? That's what God does for us before we know him. But friends, after we know him, God is still doing the same thing. He is knocking on the door in certain areas of our lives to get our attention. He wants to get our will so that he can do his. One of the ways he does that is that we who have ears to hear should pay attention and discern what the Spirit is trying to tell us. And we do that by asking God to give us a heart for people. That is a chief way of loving the Lord, of trying to hear what the Spirit is telling us, because he's usually telling us ways in which we can help other people. We are God's vessels. We are his hands and his feet, and he wants to work through us to the people he has put around us in our lives so that he can show them his love. Pay attention to what people are going through, and then act, pray, do something to help them. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, please help us, Lord, to pay attention, Lord. And we pray for a greater level of discernment, Lord, to love people, God, to help them, Lord. Help us to have those ears when they're saying something, but they're not saying it, but we hear what they're not saying. And help us to have those eyes, God, when they're doing something, but they're not doing it. But we're seeing what they're really doing. We're seeing what's going on in their hearts, God. And help us to have this, Lord, so that we can pray for them, so that we can encourage them, so that we can give them the word that they need right at the same hour that they need it, God, by the power of your Holy Spirit, so that we can be your hands and feet to people, Lord, to young people, to old people, Lord, to our neighbors and coworkers, to our spouses, to our kids. Help us, Lord, to be your eyes, be your ears, God, so that people just kind of get that word or get that encouragement, God, or get what they need, get that prayer, God, to make things go a little bit easier for them. And we thank you, God, that you have people working, Lord, doing the same thing for us by your amazing grace. We love you, God, and we bless you, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you guys so much for spending this time with me. If you enjoyed this devotional, please be sure to subscribe to my channel, like, and comment on this video. I would appreciate it, and I would love to have you guys. Guys, have a great day. God loves you so much. I love you guys. I appreciate you watching. I will see you next time, and God bless you.